Before we get started, please subscribe to my channel below and click on the alert notification symbol. That way you'll be notified every time we publish a new video.
Now with the islands already built and they're there, you can drive on top of them, walk on top of them. Now we have a more diversified client base and we have a lot of foreigners.
Initially you said you would take people out and there was nothing to see, so you were just pointing at pieces of ocean and saying, your lot or your condo will be over there.
Wow, yes. We managed to build a demo island affordably. Affordably was hundreds of thousands of dollars. And we would take customers to the islands and trying to explain in 19 hectares where the plot of land that we were going to sell was located. It was kind of difficult. We were talking about where the birds were landing, where the water was changing, I mean, colors. I mean, it was very difficult. Nonetheless, I still remember when this is a good anecdote, I still remember going with my bankers there in the helicopter and landing on the demo island. And they asked me, Marvelous, this is a very beautiful piece of property, but who are you going to sell to these properties? And we looked around. This is a very dense city. We have probably over 100 buildings right next to each other, I mean, in front of us. I said, to all of these people living here. And they said, why would they buy if they're already in front of the ocean? I said, because they want to live better. That's it. Simple. Panama is very dense. What we do is very, very differentiated products. We don't get involved in any cookie cutter development. We just don't do that. One of the rules of the thumb is that the intrinsic value of what we are developing has to be higher than the replacement cost. If we are competing on if we can build this cheaper or do this, you know, cut corners here, cut corners there, we don't get involved. That's not our business. We like differentiation. We like niches. Niches does not mean that it's small developments, because our developments are not small. Niches mean that there is a limited or no competition, not forever, but for a certain period of time. And we managed to then, you know, move, you know, promote our development accordingly, not with the price tag, because that's just not what we do. I mean.
And it was very interesting because you could see the islands being developed in the Bay of Panama. You were selling them without any obvious advertising. So really they were selling to people that you knew, people that knew the company, that were familiar with the company, happy and comfortable investing with you. So it's been amazing to see that happen. It's now the most expensive real estate in the whole of Panama City. So fantastic to see that done. And that's just one of the projects you've done in Panama City. And your focus has always been on master planned communities. And any of you who've heard me talk at conferences will know that I tell you there's a lot to be said for living like a local, but there's an awful lot more to be said for living in gated private master plan communities. When you're a buyer, they're a fantastic way to protect your property value. You won't have the house next door turning into a nightclub or a tire shop, which can happen even when it shouldn't happen in Latin America. So your focus has always been on master plan communities, and in particular luxury master plan communities that are in a niche. So you started with, I think the big one that really sticks in my mind is Embassy Club, which was in a part of Panama City that hadn't really been sold as a residential area. The American Embassy at the time was moving house from one area to another. Big chunk of land became available, which is hence the name Embassy Club. This was an area that really was untried and untested for residential living, and you decided that you were going to do something different there. It was going to be master planned. It was going to be a resort style living for wealthy, well-off Panamanians and foreigners as well. And that worked out extremely well.
Well, in there ended up being a community like no other in Panama, because I would say over 85% of the residents are foreigners. So it is truly one of the very few very, very international communities. That wasn't the purpose at the beginning, but it was, I would say, one of the very few developments that offered what that type of buyer was looking for. These are people that are working in the surrounding areas, in the UN headquarters, that are, the regional headquarters are located in Panama, the US Embassy. You have all the canal activity. The canal is huge. The canal handles 6% of the global world trade. So there's a lot of economic activity around Embassy Club, and that allowed us to diversify our client base dramatically and command very good rents for the property owners. Yes, definitely.